I need on a different planet. Now maybe if I can work out the reason, I can get home.
Yeah, baby! Yeah!
All his friends wake up too.
Hello, everyone.
Here comes Bot.
We're sorry to interrupt this program, but we have a news flash.
Pew, pew, Barney McGrew, Tuffet, Dibble, Gruff. Pew, pew, Barney McGrew.
As you can see, it's very useful indeed, having arms as long as Mr. Tickle's.
Here is the clock, telling the time for Trumpton.
Time flies by when I'm the driver of a train, and I ride on the footplate, there and back again.
you want to look at this?
Yeah.
Hello. I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm having a dinner party and I seem to run out of coffee.
You can be anything you want to be there.
You can see anything you want to see there.
There's excitement in the air for you and me there. Fancy free there, take your family there, but you've got to be there.
Yeah.
You just got to be there. See what you want to see. Seven holes, the key there. Be there.
Got to be there.
Hello customers, it's nearly 6 o'clock. Pack up and piss off.
Hello, hey! Everybody!
Hello!
Happy birthday to you.
Hey!
Oh, thanks, Silla Love.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Do you want to look at this?
Do you want to look at this?
Do you want to look at that?
Hello and welcome to a surprise
ad hoc.
Ad hoc pop up Wig and Slingback.
I'm 51 and I'm feeling 21.
Yeah. So I'm going to open this fizz. Do you want to open it or should I?
No, you can do it. Peggy might kick off a bit.
She's not about, but if she hears it, like, she will.
She doesn't like cocks porking.
She doesn't like corks popping.
That's what I meant. Corks popping. Oh.
Yay!
And we're having... This is only my first one, by the way. I've not been drinking today. This is called a... What's it called? Pina Colada Mimosa.
Pina Colada Mimosa.
And it's one part...
Malibu.
Malibu. Or Cocoa Beer, if you buy it from Aldi. One part pineapple juice.
And you top it up with champers.
It's called... Prosecco.
Champers or Prosecco.
Cheers, dolls.
Happy birthday.
Cheers, my darlings.
And happy birthday to all of you out there who have a birthday
coming
in
soon.
2023.
Mm. Nice, isn't it?
It's really nice. Shari's here, I think, and she will testify that it is a lovely drink. So let's have a look. Who's here? Because we didn't think anyone would be here.
I thought it was just me and Jamie.
So Shari's here. She had a little heads up that we were going live. So she was waiting outside the door. In she came. Chums fan 1243 is here. Linda Lee Hughes is here. Lovely Lucy. Chums fan 1243 has let us know my birthday's coming up soon. Pauline Grant is here. Hello, Pauline. Stuart Cahoon.
Stuart bloody Cahoon.
Stuart Cahoon, pretty soon you'll be followed by Lee Ludlow.
No doubt, and there he is.
And there he is. Both of you get to isolation.
Get to isolation, Cahoon.
Linda LaHughes' birthday is on July the 16th, which is bingo night. Seven Network says bonus session. Feels like we've been here all week.
I know we're spoiling you, my darlings.
Mad ABBA fan, happy birthday, Alan. Hello, darlings. Nibbles, Bubbles has got deja vu. Linda, I've said come and play bingo for your birthday. Chums fan 1243.
It's my birthday
it says
soon.
Jamie, yeah. It's my birthday soon. Yeah. Lee Ludlow's talking about getting his dabber out. Yeah. Lee Ludlow and Stuart Cahoon, they're over in Belfast, aren't they?
Yeah.
I want you to come and play bingo with us, boys.
I wonder whether we can do a live.
Wonder if we can get to bingo in Belfast. Cilla Black is here, the legendary ghost that haunts our pub. Lovely to see you, Cilla. Shari said it's now a celebration for Alan. Of course it is. Chumsfan1243 says, mine's coming up soon.
Isn't it?
Happy birthday for soon. BG Bear is here. Happy birthday, Alan. Greg Musson is here. Happy birthday, Alan. Love you guys.
Thank you, Greg.
Seven Network says, happy big birthday plus one, Alan.
Thank you, darling.
Joshua Spencer is here. Oh, happy birthday,
Alan. I thought you were in Butlins. I
thought you were in Heidi Highland. BG Bear's just caught us popping up after finishing the first episode of Seasiders, which we were talking about yesterday.
And
we know the Welsh boys have been watching Seasiders. We were chatting to them yesterday about it after the live.
Yeah.
It's fun. It's very funny. Get watching it. Will Venus is here.
Will Venus.
Will and Mr. Venus left Alan a little birthday message.
I did. I had the pleasure of seeing them both this morning.
We've never seen Mr. Venus
no.
before.
No.
But we've seen lots of Will Venus.
They left me a little message wishing me happy birthday. And it was so lovely to see your little beautiful faces.
Who else is here? Anyone else that's joined us? Shari says, I love Alan so much. I've switched Emmerdale off. Thank you, Shari. Lee and the Ludlow and Cahoon cahoots were watching EastEnders and have stopped that.
Oh, I feel so special.
Mr. Venus is here. Hiya, dolls. Happy birthday,
hey,
Alan.
Hey, Mr.
Chuck.
Venus.
SG Turner is here.
SG Turner.
SG Turner.
Get to isolation.
David Charles is currently in the Hampton Wick Tandoori celebrating your birthday.
Oh, that's nice of you. That's nice of you, David Charles.
Can I let everyone into a little cheeky secret? The last time I went for a meal with David Charles, he was Julie Peasgood's phone a friend on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
Oh, really?
Yeah. What a story. I don't think she phoned him. I think she chose a different friend.
Oh.
Cilla Black is raising a glass to you. Ross McCrory is here. Hi,
Ross.
Ross,
darling. Hello again.
BG Bear says you're a wee bear and you're 5 years younger than him.
I'm a wee bear.
Bubbles needs to get a glass of Vimto. Pauline Grant wants some fizz.
Vimto.
Did I say Vimto?
Yeah, Vimto.
I meant Vino.
Vino. Vino de Milo, Miss Babs.
Get some Vimto. I'm reading too quickly. Hang on. Who else is here? Paul McFarlane is here. Happy birthday, Alan. You're 21, but with 30 years of experience.
Yes, that's how I to look at things.
Scylla's carting up a crate of that sparkling Bulgarian table wine that's got the champagne label stuck on it.
Oh, blow the stuff that, Scylla.
Dale Ibbotson is here. Good evening, Dale. Hi, love.
Hello, Dale, my darling.
Joel Hazeldine is
Joel
here.
Hazeldine.
Hazeldine song? Who's leaving who? Is it Joel? Is it you? Won't you tell me who's leaving who? Would you believe it? We've not even drunk anything yet.
I know. We haven't, honestly.
Woonala Dreaming is here.
Ooh.
Woonala Dreaming.
Woonala Dreaming.
Woonala Dreaming.
Get yourself to isolation.
What does Woonala Dreaming sound like?
Sounds like a sort of like meditation tape.
Yeah, don't come in. I'm listening to my Woonala Dreaming.
Taking the citrone of the crystals.
Coral Daft is here. Hi, Coral.
On the jam shed, Coral. How's it work, night?
Kath Wells is here. Hi, Kath. Ellen Meadows is here. Gosh, there's lots of you. Caroline Ibbotson is here. Hi, Caroline. We missed you yesterday. Linda LaHughes says you share your birthday with Audrey Hepburn.
I do.
Do you know who I share my birthday with? Bobby G off of Bucks Fizz.
I share myself better with somebody out of Bucks or the Fizz.
Do you? Who?
I'm sure someone put it on Facebook today.
Who is there a Fizz birthday today? Find out for
Find
us,
out
people.
For me. It might be...
Jeff Cook is here. Jeff says, happy birthday, Alan. Hello, Jeff. Simon B has just cut into his Christmas cake in honour of your birthday, Alan.
Oh, happy Christmas.
Are you having it with cheese?
Happy Christmas, Simon.
Christmas cake and cheese. Kim Peterson is here.
Kim! And
we,
Jens.
And we know the Danish for hi now, don't we?
Hey.
Hi.
Oh.
Hi. Gareth from Porto's here. Hi, Gareth. David Moore is here. Kath Wells is having strawberries and cream Baileys. Got it for $9.99 on a ferry to Guernsey. Gareth has just paused Prisoner. Spoiler. He says Powell's family have just been blown up in a car bomb.
I remember
I said it very quickly in case...
No spoilers.
Yeah, no spoilers.
I remember that episode.
But you'd have thought they'd all been more careful after what happened to Fletch the Lech. It's Jay's birthday from Bucks Fizz.
Yes.
We're linked by the Fizz.
We're linked by the
Fizz birthdays.
Bloody Fizz.
Simon B, BG Bear. Okay, that's everyone over in my side. Cilla Black would like to remind us all that it was played by the wonderful and late Judith McGrath. McGrath. I wonder if she haunts the...
Po-face.
Haunts the Wigan Slingback in Oz.
Through the door this time in the snug was... Sarah Simpson.
With Elaine. The Simpson.
Sarah and Elaine Simpson. followed by Martin Garden Spence.
Up in Aberdeen.
Up in Aberdeen.
I am in Aberdeen on May the 22nd, but I'm only there for a day and in and out.
As they say, as the vicar said to the actress. Followed by Carol Brooks. And there's Joel William Hazeldine over in this room, cuddling his little dog, Molly.
He's wishing you a yabba-dabba-doo time on your birthday.
Yabba-doo time. We'll have a gay old time. Jason Eleanor Rigby has popped in to say hello. Followed by lovely Mark, who says he's only popping for a wee bit because he's nursing his little fella,
He's Ricky. Nursing Ricky.
What else have we got in?
Gareth Webb!
Gareth Webb, my darling. Hello, sweetheart.
Hello, my lovely Gareth.
He's lovely, isn't he?
He is.
My lovely Gareth.
He is.
And his lovely fellow, his lovely man.
We've bonded over a plate of chips.
We did, and a couple of bitters.
And a smashed burger. Alex Johnson is here. Alex Johnson's staying at their mum's, so they've nicked a bit of gin and having a cheeky G&T in your honour, Alan.
Thank you, my darling. Andrew Storr says, Mel from the Creative Isolationist said, happy birthday, you old bugger. Oh, she's got beef with me, hasn't
happy
she?
Happy birthday back to her.
She's got beef paste with me, that one.
Gary and Debbie Coxhill.
The Coxhills!
We've not. Where are you
where
at
are
the
you
moment?
In the world now?
Jet setters.
Followed by Tom Chalice. Hello, Tom. Are you new, darling?
I'm trying to think of a song that goes with Paul Chalice, but I can't. My brain's not working as quickly as it should.
Followed by lovely Gabrielle, she'll say, got your lovely card this morning, my darling. Thank you so much for that. Marilyn, how are you? On my 18th birthday, simpa simpa. A lovely Jay Shaw.
No, Marilyn Tau is actually telling you that her birthday is on the 18th.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Not that you're 18.
Wishful thinking.
Everyone stop telling us when your birthdays are. It's this one's birthday today. We're celebrating Alan.
I don't mind them telling me. If I remember, I'll say happy birthday. Although, no, Marilyn follows our good friend Rita Webb.
Oh, okay.
So we normally cross paths there, don't we, darling? Lovely Jay Shaw.
Wanula Dreaming says they will put us all to sleep. And it's actually Nick from Derby.
Yeah, I think Jay Shaw was asking about our pie incident with Carolida.
Carolida and the salmon pie.
Ooh. Yeah, he said he's still jealous. Salmon
we'll tell
pie
you about it one day.
And little potatoes.
We have spoken about it in
we
the Wigan
We didn't poison
back.
Them. I feel like...
that's like tub syrup.
We didn't kill them.
I didn't burn them.
Shall I just quickly say what the pie incident was?
No, let's leave it as a mystery.
Jamie Wright... says hello birthday, hello handsome. That's it. Joe Jarvis. Hi ho, happy birthday, Alan. Thank you, I'm glad. Susan Elizabeth George. She sounds like a theatrical actress.
She says we're spoiling you with three appearances. I know you'll all be fed up with us.
I know you'll be going, turn blue TV off.
Oh, there's someone there that I've not seen before. Hang on. New name. Sarah Scarborough Lemon.
Oh, that's hello, look at her little face.
Hello, Sarah Scarborough Lemon.
Are you from America?
Are you from Scarborough? In the UK or in Canada?
Her picture looks very sunny, so I presume she's not in Britain.
Carrie Louise K. Lou is here. Hi, Carrie Louise.
Carrie Louise K. Lou. You're off to isolation.
Carrie Louise says, someone else who likes Christmas cake and cheese. All my friends think I'm weird. I blame my dad. He's a Yorkshireman in the south of England.
I've been craving fruitcake this week, haven't I?
BG Bear wants to get a shout out over this side of the room as well, as does Paul McFarlane.
Yeah, they're my boys. My boys.
Gareth Webb's just popping in for a quick wink harness.
Yeah.
And a bag of scampi fries.
It's lovely to see you, Gareth. I know you don't pop in Wednesdays because you're busy, but it's lovely to see you tonight.
I saw a lovely name there we've not seen for a little while in the Wigan Slingback.
Lorna.
The lovely Lorna Spencer. Hi, Lorna.
Hello,
darling.
Lorna, love. Thank you for my birthday, love.
And then, popping in fashionably late, is our favourite Welsh redhead, Mark Hall. Yakida.
He's been shopping for some coronation tea.
Don't scratch that around, it'll make lots of noise on the mic.
Say sorry.
Sarah Scarborough Lemons from the US.
Yeah, I knew, I could tell.
Over this side, I'm missing all loads of messages, but we've got lots of Stuart Cahoon's being very chatty in the... Lots of Stuart Cahooning. He says, Stuart Cahoon says, I fancy a baby sham. Can you still buy it?
Yes, you can. From Iceland. Do you have Iceland in Belfast?
I would think so. They must have Iceland.
Very it'll expensive,
be called,
though.
It'll be called Iceland. What, I call, that's a Belfast accent.
Iceland.
No.
Iceland. Iceland.
Iceland.
Get you down to Iceland.
Who else? Diangela is here. Diangela says, happy birthday to our amazing Alan. Pip is here. Shalom. Sorry I can't say, but happy birthday, Alan. David Charles, it might interest you to know that I was going to be having dinner with Mandana Jones and Nikki Wade from Bad Girls, but she couldn't make it last minute.
What now? Tonight?
I don't know who Mandana Jones is, but I love the name. I love the sound of Mandana Jones. Was Mandana Jones, did they play Nikki Wade in Bad Girls?
I don't remember Bad Girls. I don't know.
Nikki Wade, I think, was she a lesbian who might have had barbed wire tattooed around her neck?
Okay.
And she had little sort of youngish blonde-haired girlfriend. Lesbian partner who looked like Gareth Gates.
Yeah, possibly.
Might be. I might be totally wrong. Anyone else? Emma Webb is here. Emma Webb, thank you for joining us. Happy birthday. To him. Not, she's saying happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Thank you, very glad. Would you have a little sip? Take a little sip.
So we've had a nice day, haven't we?
Yeah. I woke up this morning.
Will Venus has corrected me. I'm thinking of Danny Blood. Of course I am thinking of Danny Blood.
got your character wrong.
Will, who's Nikki Wade? You let me know. Will knows his Bad Girls.
Woke up this morning with a ding-dong on the door. With postman, didn't we?
Yes.
Delivery man. And a little box. It says, open today. Open now. And I opened it, and there was a box of donuts.
Let me bring up a picture. Hang fire. Give us a minute. So, Alan received this little...
Look at that.
Krispy Kremes, no less. Birthday Krispy Kremes.
From Nibbles and Bubbles. How excited were we?
Yeah, happy birthday, Krispy Kremes.
Happy birthday to you.
So that was a lovely start to the day.
Yeah.
So we had popped the coffee on, wolfed one, and then we had Nibbles pop round, didn't we?
Yeah, then strolling down our boulevard was Mr. Nibbles, who was going to pop a card through Alan's flat. But we said, no, pop in.
Pop in and get yourself a donut.
So he came in. Just to chip in, Nikki Wade was the tough, short-haired one who got off with the Scottish female governor. Totally know who you
I
mean
know,
now.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they were, like, lesbian royalty, weren't they, for the start of the of the show.
Happy birthday to you.
You can never have too much Scylla popping in.
So that was a lovely surprise, wasn't it?
Yes. Yeah.
And they were beautiful.
Yeah, we had one, and of course Mr. Nibbles had one as well. Mm. But Bubbles hasn't had one yet. So then we were stuck in because
we were waiting for a parcel
to come from Yodel. And it took forever. It didn't come until...
6 o'clock tonight.
Yeah, 6 o'clock tonight.
And I had to wait for it, because if I don't wait for it, it'll go back to the depot, and it'll be another week, and I need it soon, so it was a bit of a pain. So, Yodel around here is awful. It's really bad.
I've got a really red nose tonight.
But we had a nice day, didn't we? We had Scylla playing a lot of the day, didn't we?
Yeah, we actually had Scylla playing nearly all day.
We had a lot of Scylla playing.
And I've got all the speakers around the house, so we had Scylla throughout the house playing.
And then I had some cards, didn't I? Because some of you sent me lovely cards and presents.
You've brought some up, haven't you?
I have, yeah, sure. Come and look.
We'll show you these little things in a minute.
Spot up and ready.
There we go.
There we go.
Did you put those back for me? Thank you very much.
They were in the way.
So, I brought a few of the cards up. Obviously, can't show you all of them, but I thought I'd show you a few. So, if I don't show you a card, I'm sorry, but if I do show you a card, you'll recognise it. So that's one of my first ones I opened, which is from Lady V and Neil and Little Lord Henry. And it's a lovely card with the lovely Daniel LaRue on the front.
It says, watch Daniel LaRue, and then it says, no, sorry, I can't, it's Alan's birthday.
Ah, so thank you, guys. A lovely little picture of me and Lady V in the back there.
Can you see it?
Can you see it? I don't think they're looking at it.
Look at it.
So this one I love, which is from Pete and Cena. There we go. And that's lovely Joan there with an axe.
The message in this is funny. Read the message in this one.
It says, just one present for you this year, Alan, an axe. And the rest will go to the orphanage. Love me, dearest. I like it. This is from Phil and Richard Bobbins Duffer.
A cavalcade of mollies with all different hair colours.
You know, I love a bit Mrs. Slocum, don't you? And so do they.
And then there's a molly on the back as well. Mr. Humphreys, leave my pussy alone.
And speaking of, can you see it? Look what I got.
See it?
Can you see her?
Can you see her?
I don't think they're looking at it. So, yeah, my first Pam Pie card. And I think that's from Tracy 30, isn't it?
Yeah.
With Earl and Tracy from the United States of America.
So that's come across.
And thank you if you're watching, Tracy and Earl, for my present and my book.
I don't think Tracy 30's here.
Now this, I was impressed with. Look at that. Do you see that, Cilla?
So it's Cilla Black. And just a look at what's blending into her right leg is a large orange. And then just below her left leg are three OXO cubes.
Yeah. And I thought the boys had photoshopped it into like a sort of, you know, like a card image. And then I realised, oh, they've actually just done a still life and took a photo of it. Isn't that wonderful? Look at that. And they haven't forgotten our lovely grot bags Carolee's got there. Look. And she's putting me in the picture.
And the Welsh boys would like 12 wallaby hops. They can't have them. I'm an announcer, not Fatima Whitbread.
The lovely Nibbles and Bubbles created this, which was me. Last Eurovision, dressed as none other than Nana Mouskouri. Well, that's lovely, isn't it? And there we all are there, having a little party there. Nibbles and Bubbles card. And this is from Mark, Ricky and Milo. You can guess what that is, can't you?
Start your engines and may the best birthday begin.
Thank you, boys. This is from Martin and Stephen.
So that's from the proprietors. Is that the right word? Of the Howls of S&M.
So thank you, boys. And then the last one I'm going to show is this from Joel and the Simpsons.
So from Hazel Dean and the Simpsons.
Yeah.
Who's leaving who?
And I'm very, very chuffed to see that they've included my Fiona.
That's them.
That's them there.
That's them having
the OXO challenge. And there's me, obviously, in all my different guises with Jamie. And I think Peggy's there. They never leave Peggy out, do they? They're lovely. So thank you for that. For that beautiful card. There we go. And then not only cards, but I got some presents as well, didn't I?
Presents through the post. So
the first one I'd show you is this that I got from the S&M boys, which is a lovely whiskey liqueur with cinnamon.
Well, yeah, it's Alcoholic though, isn't it?
Yeah, when we went round to see them, they gave me a couple of shots of this. So I'll be looking forward to trying that.
And they've said we could have it in, you can have a little nip in cider. And it makes it taste like apple pie. Welsh boys, you got any of that in your cabinets?
Well, they're gin boys, aren't they? They're not whiskey.
Well, they've
boys.
They've got all manner.
Oh, have they? It's not just gin.
I don't think they've just got gin. BG Bear says, isn't that what the youngsters drink? Charles H 34 says, nothing good ever happens after a bottle of Fireball.
We might turn into Fireballs.
Shall we have a look?
This one. Yeah. From Joel and Elaine and Sarah. Look what they got. We don't own one.
That'd be proper useful as well. Because it's really useful for me to do this to link sound and vision together.
So we're
and
actually going to use
other cameras as well. Because,
as a proper clapperboard.
Because that's like a strike that you can line up. So
and also,
they're really useful.
It's the one you can actually chalk on, isn't it?
We'll put silly things on here, but that will be proper useful.
Now, Coral, who's
done the other bits with that.
Coral, who's one of our lovely followers, who's been to visit us and watched our bingo, sent me a lovely little selection of presents.
Coral's in, I think.
Oh, she's in. Of course, she's in. Yeah. So she sent me that, which is one of my favourite films. Which, if you don't know the film, it's a magnificent film with Beryl Reed and Susanna York. And the third actress in that is Coral Brown. She's amazing, isn't she?
Yeah. She's like Joan Ferguson in it, really.
Yeah. And not only did Coral send us the, send me and, Jamie was going to love this as well, the DVD, but the play script.
Yeah, the script, Samuel French script as well.
Yeah. And
then we thought, we could do an all-male version.
The book... about Coral Brown, which we've been flicking through, and she's look, a proper character, isn't she?
Yeah, I didn't know anything about Coral Brown, but reading the fly leaf, as one does, she sounds really fascinating, really camp and fun and scandalous. And it says here, her famous lovers included Maurice Chevalier, Paul Robeson, Cecil Beaton and Douglas Fairbanks Jr. Gay men adored her for her sense of camp and her rapier wit. Some even succumbed to her physical charms, causing her to comment when pictured curtsying to the monarch, "There's another photo of me going down on an old queen."
So that's going to be a magnificent read. And Coral is actually named after Coral Brown. So that was a lovely collection there, Coral. Thank you. Tracy 30... I've not brought it up, but sent me the Harry Hill board game, which we're going to enjoy playing, aren't we? And she also sent this, which I will love reading as well, which is a book about the late Paul O'Grady, who left us recently.
Well, it's Paul O'Grady's biography, autobiography of the Savage Years. Mm. So it'll be a really fascinating part of his life as well.
So reading that. The lovely Sandwell sent me this, which is a book on Uther, and all you Uther fans will know it's quite hard to find out about what Uther got up to because she was very private. But this is like the third in the series of books that have been written by Paul Curran. So they bought me that, which I don't have. So I look forward to reading that.
Well, then we got like a mammoth.
Oh yeah, the
box from The Simpsons.
The Simpsons and Joel.
Joel and Hazel Dean, which includes.
Now they know we're vegetarian because they you know Christmas and birthdays they send us lots of lovely sweets, but look what they sent us. Meat-free Oxos.
Beef flavour.
Now, I didn't know these existed, did you?
No, so we can actually do... We can properly do Cilla.
Do Cilla's Oxo. Because we can't really do it with the vegetable stock cubes, can we? But we've got these now, so we can enjoy the experience. The same as you guys.
And they know that we love
and
all
they know,
things.
Yeah, they know we love all
Yakidar.
Things. Yakidar. With our Welsh boys. And they sent me this, which is cookbook.
A Welsh cookbook.
Which is, well, lamb we wear most we won't use, but leeks and lava bread.
The best of Welsh cookery.
And look how lovely they are. They've actually put little bookmarks to tell us where pescatarian recipes are and vegetarian. Isn't that sweet?
It's Neil Sandwell's here, or Lady V.
Hello, darlings.
We just showed your card and your present.
And not only that, but obviously we're like, where do we get lava bread from? No worries, because they sent some. Look at that.
So we've got some lava breads.
And Joel recently said to me that he thought of these presents because he just recently lost his Welsh uncle.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that,
so
Joel.
We said that we would create some recipes in honour of him.
Well, the pies will. Mrs. Pie might cook some Welsh food.
With lava bread. Or as, what did I call it? Laughter bread.
Laughter bread.
With, what was the name?
I'm not sure.
The driving woman.
Maureen Rees.
And in the little, in the birthday box was a key, which he said we can use for our Prisoner Subblockage filming.
Yeah, we don't know what it unlocks.
Yeah.
It's a large key.
So we shall use that because it'll go on my my costume chain. But
The main present the from main Sarah present and Elaine and Joel
was this. Look at that.
Can you see that? Can you see it?
Can they see it?
I know they're looking at it.
They're looking at it.
Isn't that fabulous, look?
You know, my reflection on it. It's hard to show you. So it's on the inside, the theme from Prisoner Subblockage, sung by Lynn Hamilton. And it's a framed single.
Isn't that lovely? So all that came in a big, big box that I opened this morning. It's Alexa. She's talking to somebody downstairs.
Hang on.
She's playing music downstairs.
Let me go and find out what that noise is.
Unless it's next door. So that was another big surprise. Big box of presents from the guys there. And I got some lovely sweets from Jamie's brother and sister-in-law. And Jamie's parents bought me a lovely bird bath to go in the garden, which goes under the bird house that they bought me last year. So the birds are having a gay old time in our garden. And from my folks, I got lots and lots of money, which will go towards costumes and things like that. Was it her?
Yeah, I don't know what was going on.
I won't say her name, but she was kicking off downstairs playing music.
Yeah, dead loud.
Yeah. Lots of lovely presents. And lots of lovely wishes sent to me throughout the day on social media. So I've been spot rotten. And then Jamie, mid-morning, presents this beautiful cake. Look at that.
So this...
Is that it made?
Yeah, I can't cook.
And it's my favourite cake, which is tres leches, and coconut, and pink things. And those... they're those sweets, aren't they? Raffaello?
Yeah, so I said... The baker that I hired to make it sent me pictures saying, what do you want it decorated like? So I chose kind of a cake design. But then I said, it's just not gay enough. I want it really gay. So I said, I want it kind of like the sort of thing that Fanny Craddock might make. Ta-da! And this is what we got.
Isn't it lovely? I'm not adding it yet. It's still whole.
So it's tres leche cake. I didn't make it, obviously.
It's so pretty. I was like amazed. I don't think I've had a cake in years. Have I?
No. And there's a load of presents.
Oh, now that's what Joel and Elaine and Sarah sent us. Look, all that.
All of that inside.
Postcards. The little beer mats with our faces on. Look.
Yeah, down here.
Yeah. And that was from Dale and Caroline, and the Noel of old retro books.
A swap shop annual.
Yep.
The Goodies book, Morecambe and Wise annual special, and a Doctor Who annual from 1978.
And it's the Tom Baker, isn't it, Doctor Who?
Yes.
My Doctor.
We saw them. Let's go back. That was from Tracy 30, so the Harry Hill board game, yep. And Paul O'Grady. And from the Sandwell's Youth of Joyce book. Yep.
Oh, and that's from Coral. That's from Coral. The Coral Collection. So, yeah, I've had a lovely day. And I was just saying about your mum and dad's bird bath.
Happy birthday to you.
So, yeah, how exciting.
And thank you, Kim and Jens, for your little donation to me.
Oh, yeah, Kim and Jens.
Sent me some Danish krona.
And Charlie Mitchell.
Yeah, he sent me a little Amazon voucher. And I think some of you guys sent me something last night.
Sonia D is here.
Look at me.
I'm Sonia D. Hello, Sonia. Thank you for your message this morning. We had about four people send us those deets. So I can't do it, but Alan's having a think about it. Paul McFarlane sent you a lovely poem.
He did send me a lovely poem. I shall put that on a image and publish it, because I don't want it to be hidden away.
I'm going
to
bring in something for you.
Oh, is it a surprise?
Yes.
Oh, Chuffinora. So yeah, Paul, that was a lovely poem. Jamie actually read it out to me, and I had a little tear. Lovely.
This is your birthday present from me.
From you?
Yes.
Oh, I thought you were going to wait till later.
No, but you can have this one now.
This one?
Because people...
Which means there's more.
People will like to see it.
What should I do?
This one.
Oh, is it a plant? No. He's like a little dolly.
Oh. So I've been working on this for a little while.
Have you? You've been working on it?
No, like, it's getting it.
Getting it made? Oh. No.
No.
I've seen leopard print. Is it cherry stump?
Oh. Take her out of her little bag.
Oh, my word. Oh, my God.
Show everyone at home.
I'm crying and laughing at the same time. Look at the cherry stump. Oh my God.
It's a cherry stump doll.
Oh, she's got little blue beads. And she's got a fag. Oh my Lord.
So they come with little... She's got a little cig.
She's got a little hair. She's got syrup. Is that syrup? It's what I wore in the bingo, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, and she's got big boobs. Look at that.
She's been built to look like you.
Oh. Isn't she beautiful?
Hold her up a bit so people can see her cig.
Look at that. And she's got little red nails.
She's got eyelashes.
And she's got little blue earrings.
She's got eyelashes. Look at her eye... Look at her eye makeup.
Oh my God. Oh, and she's got little goofy teeth.
Look at her little eye makeup. She's not like the red and blue that you do.
Oh my God. Who has made this wonderful creature? Look at the little face.
And this.
Jason said, does that have a cord that says, frig off?
I wish. Wouldn't that be amazing?
Oh my God. Oh, she's got movable legs. Oh, the only thing that isn't right is she's got knickers on.
Don't, because the doll maker will be watching this.
I'm joking. I think it's beautiful. Whoever you are, you've done an amazing job.
And then...
Is it brandy? It's another one, isn't it? Oh, my word. I'm being really slow and fragile. Oh, it's brandy! Oh, my word. Oh my lord, look at that. Oh wow. Oh, she is beautiful. Look at that. Oh, look at the beauty, like hair, haven't they? Well, not real hair.
She's got a cig as well.
She's got a cig.
Hang on, she's pinned to her hip.
Oh my word. Look at the beard. Look at Brandy's beard.
Let's get that out of her eye.
Oh,
they've got little cigs, so she's got a cig as well.
They're amazing.
Show everyone Brandy's feet.
Look at their lovely legs.
She's got her cork wedges on.
And they're made of cork. It's real cork. Oh, wow. And she's got a little pink jacket.
She's got my little... Yeah.
And your little belt.
They've got a little cig. They've each got a cig.
Oh. Whoever's made these have captured us, like, perfectly. Haven't they?
So these are made by a craftswoman in just outside of York who makes these amazing dolls. Now, normally the dolls she makes are sort of like fairies and spirits, and they look like they look very like sort of the Dark Crystal kind of characters.
Oh my lord!
But yeah, I commissioned her to make Sherry and Brandy, and I think she's done an amazing job.
Amazing. And look, she's even got some double chins. I'm glad she's not been polite.
They're hinged as well, and, so that you can pose them.
You know, she's captured me as I truly am, a big northern lass. Oh, I think they're beautiful.
Do you love them?
Oh, I think they're amazing.
But then I've got also... So this is like a, these are stands, so we can put them in doll stands so they'll stand up.
Oh, look at that. They've got little sequin shoes on.
Oh. Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you. I'm filling up, look.
So thanks. So these are made by Irene, and her company is called The Sanctuary Shed. So Sanctuary Shed, well, not her company, her. She makes these in her back garden, in the shed.
Thank you so much, Irene. They're amazing. I love it. Did you have to sort of send photos of us?
And I had to describe us as well.
Look at Brandy's loops.
Yeah. I said that Brandy always wears big loops and Sherry has danglers.
I just love the details, like the beard and the little colouring of the beard.
Yeah. She's done the loops, beard colouring.
Pink jacket. Sherry's little blue earrings. Her beads.
Sherry's got blue and pink eyeshadow.
Yep, the makeup and the little double chins and the big hair and the little dress I wore on that day. And the fag. Oh, look, they've got a fag.
And your boobs.
And the boobs. Oh, amazing.
Let me put them somewhere safe so Peggy doesn't maul them.
Oh, wow. I'm overwhelmed by that.
Thank you, Irene. They've gone down really well. Thank you, Irene.
Amazing. We'll be treasured. Forever. Wow. Oh. The things he gets me is amazing. He's just little surprises. Like last year he got me the little embroidery tapestry with Thank You Very Glad. Was that my birthday last year, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh. Daniel Dachovic. Hello from Adelaide, Australia. Hiya, Daniel.
Hi, Daniel.
Yeah, I love to get an artist to do what artists do best and create something and kind of get into it. And then you know that your money's going like to that person who's made it, who created it. So yeah, Sanctuary Shed. If anyone on Facebook wants to put a link to Sanctuary Shed,
that'd
be super.
A bit of leopard print and a painted nail. And I thought, this has only got to be one person. Oh, it's 5:30 a.m.
So happy birthday
in Adelaide. Daniel's popped in to say hello. Oh, cheers, Dals. Oh, lovely.
She loved doing it. She loved making it. She's been working on them for about a month, and she said every evening when she left her studio, she'd go good night, girls, to them, and she's been tinkering with them, and she's really excited about. seeing them. I went and met her in a coffee shop to pick them up earlier this week.
Yeah.
And they were sitting there at the table on a little chair of their own.
Did you cry like me, like a big girl?
Yeah, and then Imo was there. Cause it was,
oh, really?
Yeah, I went to Eat Me in Sitwell. And Imo came over and had a look at them, who's an artist who runs the cafe. And she loved them as well. She was going, oh my God, they look just like you. I love them.
Oh.
So, yeah. Do you like them? Don't cry. They're a nice present.
Happiness.
And yeah, she's excited about maybe making Divinity next.
That'll be fun.
But yeah, she'll make anything. She makes she loves making steampunks. She's making some mermaids at the moment. Mm. We're going to go and meet her on Sunday, because she's doing a craft fair at the Royal Hotel in Scarborough.
Oh, lovely.
And she wants to meet you. Because she's spent so...
As Sherry?
No, as you. Because she spent so long, like, looking at us. So, yeah.
Oh, thank
I'm
you.
I'm glad you like them. I wanted to open them on camera so we can send the video to Irene. If you like the dolls, hit like. Yeah, hit the like button if you like them.
I'm overwhelmed.
Oh.
You always do this to me.
I've got some other presents for you, but you'll have them when we get downstairs. Paul McFarlane says, you deserve everything you desire, Alan, my friend.
Oh, thank you.
BG Bear says, we should have a whole series of isolation creation dolls.
Mm.
Yeah, everyone commission Irene to make you a little Sherry Stump for home.
Oh, and she'll wake up at night, go through your booze cupboard.
Well, that's the thing. They might come alive at night and get up to mischief in our house. Kelly's here. Kelly says, happy birthday from Australia. Thank you, Kelly.
Thank you, Kelly love.
Andrew Chapman's also here. Says, sorry I'm late. Happy birthday, Alan.
Oh, thank you.
And me versus we says, oh, Alan, tears of joy.
Mm.
BG Bear would like a Pan Pie and Mr. Pie doll.
A Pan Pie. Well, that'd be funny, wouldn't it, those two?
Oh, Martin Garten Spencer says, the love and thought you put into that is amazing.
I know,
Jamie.
Thank you, dolls. You
thank you.
Spoil me rotten, you do.
Jay Shaw's off to enjoy. I'm going to have to go. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you very glad.
Thank you very glad, darling, for popping by.
Nigel TC says, I bet you've checked out Sherry and Brandy's downstairs.
Well, as I said, I'm wearing knickers, which is rare. Sherry does wear knickers. She does.
Sherry wears, she has to wear knickers. We have to tuck everything away, don't we?
Yeah.
Alan, get Irene to make a doll of me in the kilt. I can be with you always.
Wait, no pants for you, though, dear.
Do you want another little drink?
Pop another bit of Cocoa Bay in there.
And then we'll let these people get on with their night.
So I presume you're all looking forward to the coronation weekend. Are you celebrating or are you not? Or we'll have a little watch, won't we?
I think we'll watch it. I'm not at all a royalist, but it's like, it's a bit of history, isn't it?
Yeah, you know.
So,
it's a crowning of the king, isn't it? So it's sort of... but I must admit, I'm not all that keen on this coronation quiche. No, I'm a bit perturbed by it.
Well, you've never tried it. It might be nice.
Well, I had the quiche from Aldi, which had broccoli in it.
Broad bean and tarragon.
But broad beans and spinach.
Here's our little guest from earlier, Christopher Perinder, popping in.
Hello.
Hello, Chris. We just popped to have a little birthday
You've missed the dolls.
Video.
You'll see them Saturday.
I don't know where we'll put them.
Oh.
They have to be like on in prime show, don't they?
Yeah.
I missed everyone's messages. I hope you like the dolls.
I think people are saying night because everybody's going to work tomorrow.
Yeah.
Mark
Hall is putting his bunting up tomorrow and having family over for a coronation tea party on Sunday.
Mm.
We're off to the Eat Me Boys on Sunday, aren't we, for a little lunch. And then I think we've got Nibbles and Bubbles and the Eat Me Boys over on Saturday night for
a little
coronation spread.
Tipple. And of course, next week is Eurovision, isn't it?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah.
I go away just after Eurovision. Melissa J says, happy birthday from Canada.
Oh, thank you, Melissa.
Lee Ludlow's already got the bunting to go up. Not up yet.
Yeah, we, as in the UK, are very lucky because we're sort of getting an extra day off, aren't we? Bank holiday Monday on Monday. So that's three this month.
Three bank holidays this month.
Yeah. Yeah.
Three times this week.
Yeah.
No, it's, what does she say?
It's next door had sex again.
Oh, that's three times this month.
Or twice this month, I think. Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Melissa J. Love the dolls. So talented. Oh, I didn't make them. Irene made them at the Sanctuary Shed. She's a lovely lady. So we're going to go and meet her on Sunday.
Lovely.
At a craft fair.
Yeah.
So Alan can see
her.
Does
she sell like dolls, everything at the craft fair, or is it other things?
Yeah, yeah. She makes these dolls. They're amazing. There's the little fairies, little steampunk men and women, characters from like Alice in Wonderland. Mm. She's also got a friend who does felting and wants to make Peggy. So we've got, so Sherry and Brandy have a Peggy to go with them.
Oh, that will set me off, won't it?
Stuart Coon wonders if the little sister who was on the phones on Sunday night sobered up. Sister Mimsy.
She did, eventually. Yeah. Did she ever go down to the monastery for the blind date?
I don't think she did, Sister Mimsy. Alex is not messaging because his phone is dead and now the charger isn't working. Oh, I'm sorry, Alex.
He was busy sending me videos this morning.
Gary and Debbie Coxhill are having a street party on Sunday. The Road is having a street party on Sunday. So they've lent them their PA system, but they're going to work on their new bungalow, so they're not bothering with it.
Oh.
Yeah, Alex got behind the wheel of the double decker today, didn't he? And sent you a video of Maggie Bogg.
Of Maggie Bogg getting off the bus.
You're wishing us a happy birthday, driver.
Which was lovely of Maggie, because she must be down in Wales again.
Well, I think she's gone down to stay with the boys for the coronation. She's putting up Mark's bunting tomorrow.
Yeah.
She'll be
overseeing the party.
Tom Cluse is over in the YouTube bar and says, happy birthday, Alan. Give the bar a go. So should we let people get on with their evening?
Yeah, it's been lovely to see you all and chat with you. And I've had a lovely day. And thank you for all your lovely wishes. And
you don't have to back away from Scylla. Oh, I've been there.
Yeah, there we go. There she is. Yeah, so we'll be back with you Wednesday, won't we? Yes, we will.
Will we?
Yeah, Wednesday you're here, aren't you?
Yeah. Yes, I'm teaching Wednesday afternoon, so we can do Wednesday evening.
So have a lovely coronation weekend, those in the UK. And for everybody else, have a lovely weekend, and we'll see you Wednesday.
All right. Oh, Philippe Jacques Buttonbras is here. Have we mentioned him already this evening?
Yeah, they sent me a lovely card, didn't they?
Yes, yeah. All right, loves. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for witnessing the Sherry and Brandy dolls. We'll take some photos of them later so you can see them in all their glory.
You dropped something. You dropped your spare change.
All right, darlings.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for making my day extra special for saying happy birthday and loving me, and I love you too.
All right, night night, everyone.
Bye.
Enjoy your evening. Bye-bye. Bye.